In the French-speaking part, German is taught from the third year of primary school, English from the fifth year. In the neighbouring cantons, French begins in the third year and English also in the fifth year. But in the green-coloured cantons, English comes first and French later. Graubünden and Ticino have their own rules. Cantons Thurgau and Nidwalden are now set to break the mould. Nidwalden's education director, Rez Schmid, prefers to put more emphasis on German and maths and let the children learn their second national language at secondary school.
We're going to improve the teaching of French. We'll keep the same lessons and send children to Western Switzerland on obligatory language exchanges. This is all very promising.
Although Schmid insists that this is not a rejection of the French-speaking minority, French language newspapers have taken it badly. The headlines read, "Language battle hots up again. French is only useful for a minority of Swiss Germans." And the German cantons want a monoculture. People in the streets have also reacted angrily.
It's not good. People need to know languages to work here.
I'm against putting French last. We have to overcome the language divide.
I think we all agree that the German-speaking cantons are turning their backs on the French-speaking ones.
It's argued that the trend threatens the cohesion of Switzerland.
We find it shocking that some German-speaking cantons now want to give English priority over French. Do they want us all to speak English with each other? It would be very damaging for Switzerland.
She would like the Swiss Germans to show the same commitment to French as the people in Western Switzerland have to German. A parliamentary commission is discussing a federal law which could insist on the teaching of two foreign languages at primary school level in all cantons.